Nidadaf Mem Zayin. We left off yesterday. Rabbi Yossi was the author of Seder Olam, and he writes in Seder Olam that the chiyuv of Truma in our days is Deraisa, because the kibosh, the conquering of Ezra, lasts forever. The Gemara wants to prove that he was the author, but he himself doesn't hold that. The halacha is that Deraisa, a piece of Truma is batal b'roiv. That is, if you have two pieces of chulin and one piece of Truma, it's batal completely. Midrabanan, Truma is only batal 1 in 100. So what happens if you have a dough that has a little bit of a truma in it? According to Rabbi Yossi, it's not chayiv and chala at all, because we treat it as truma. Now that makes sense if Rabbi Yossi holds that truma is midrabanan and chala is midrabanan. So the rabbanan dimua truma could override the chiyuv of chala, which is only the rabbanan. The Gemara says one is not connected to the other. The chiyuv of chala and the chiyuv of truma are not connected. You see that there's a man d'omer that holds that it's possible that midiraisa, there's truma, and midirabanan, there's chala. In other words, chala is midirabanan, truma is deraisa, or vice versa. Right when Klai Yisrael went into Eretz Yisrael, there was a chiyuv of chala for the first 14 years, and only later on there was a chiyuv of maaser, because it says zaracha, it has to be your land. On the other hand, you could say that there's a chiyuv of chala b'zman hazeh, there's no chiyuv of chala b'zman hazeh, because it says bivoyachem, when most of Klai Yisrael is in Eretz Yisrael. But there's still a chiyuv of truma midiraisa, because the kedusha of Eretz Yisrael, the kibush, the conquering, lasts until this day. So one is not connected to the other. Whereas a boy, the Mishnah says, has two stages in his life. He's a katan or a gadol. A girl has three stages. She's a ketana, naira, and a begeris. When she's a ketana and a naira, then her father receives her maisi yadayim, any earnings, any fines, and he could be made for nedarim, he could annul her nedarim. Once she turns a begeris, she's in her own rishus. What is the shiur? Where does a girl turn from a naira to a begeris? And there are many shaitas in the Gemara. According to Rabbi Yossi Aglili, we're talking about the upper body simanim. If she puts her hands behind her back and there's a fold of skin, that's the shiur. Rabbi Akiva says they grow larger, that they lean forward. Ben Azai says that there's darkness around the oikets, the point. Rabbi Yossi says that they're large enough that if you push it in, it'll take time to come back out. Rabbi Lezer Rabbi Tzadik says, Yiskashkishu, Rashi says that's a larger shear where they bang. Rabbi Yochanan Ben Berakhia says that the actual oikets becomes darker. Rashi says he doesn't know what a chaitim is. And the Gemara is doicher because the Gemara says that's a shear for a much older woman. So Ravashi says the shear is mispatzel, there's a perforation where the milk comes out. Rabbi Yossi says that's basically the same shear as he said before, but he calls it mishetakif ha'atara. Lahalacha, we must be machmir like any one of these shitas. So therefore, if let's say a girl received kiddushin from a man and her father also received kiddushin from a man, we have to be machmer, and she needs a get from both of them. The Gemara says that Shmuel checked on his own shivcha to see the different stages, and then he gave her 4 zuz. Lahalacha, he didn't have to give her any money. There's no bishus by a slave, but he didn't want to have a din min hashamayim. In fact, the Gemara says that Shmuel was very concerned about his slaves, that they shouldn't have busha, and therefore he designated to each one of his shivchas an eved. Whereas Rav Nachman would switch off the avadim and that caused them busha. Rav Sheshes was completely mafker them and he would let them be with any Arab, but he would warn them that they should not be with a Jew. Some say that we say that we have to be makpid l'chumra, like every one of the shitas, is actually a completely different sugya. There are 5 shitas when it comes to meiser. The chiyuv of meiser is when, one of the chiyuvim is when you bring it into the house, yir pnei habayis. What if you bring it into your backyard or to your front yard? There's 5 shitas. What is considered a yard? Reb Shimon says it's considered a chotzer tzuris, and the Gemara explains that's where there's somebody watching the yard. So it's a inyan of security. How much security there is for your belongings. Reb Akiva says it's not considered secure if everybody has a key and everybody goes in and out because somebody might leave the door open. Reb Yehuda says, well, if there's a chatzar within a chatzar, so the inner chatzar has only one key, although the outer one, everybody has the key, so the inner chatzar is considered secure. Reb Nechemya says that has nothing to do with security, it has to do with privacy. That is, if you're able to eat there and you're not embarrassed by people watching you, then it's private. Reb Yossi says, if somebody just walks in off the street into the chatzar and people ask him, what are you doing here? That's considered secure. Says the Mishnah, if somebody's 20 years old, according to Beis Hillel, and they develop simanim of idleness or saris, they can no longer do chalitza or yibum. According to Beis Shammai, the age is 18, and according to Rabbi Lazar, it's 20 for a man and 18 for a woman because a woman develops quicker. What if this 20-year-old never developed any simani saris, but they just don't have simani bagros? The halacha is that they turn to be gedolim halfway through their life. Life expectancy is 70 years, so when they turn 35 and a day, that's half, and that's when they become a gadol. Up until that point, a man is like a 9-year-old where they considered his yibum like maimer begadol. If they would bring somebody like this in front of Reb Chiya, he would look at him and see if he's really healthy. He's too heavy, he'd say, you have to go on a diet. If he's too skinny, he said, let's feed this guy a little bit. According to Rav, the entire perek is me'ez leis. That is, if we say that a girl is 3 years old, that means she's completely 3 years old. She has 3 full years. So therefore, in our Mishnah, it must be that 20 years old means a complete 20. 20 in one day. But according to Ula, our Mishnah, since it doesn't mention v'yoyim echad, in all the other Mishnahs, it says gimel v'yoyim echad, etc., our Mishnah means even a 19-year-old and 30 days is also considered a 20-year-old for a saris. Have a wonderful day.